There we go.
Okay.
We're excited about this one.
What a story. That was great. So here with us right now, Andrew Adams, of course, who helped put it together, ghostless, hopefully.
Mm-hmm. I guarantee you've got ghosts following you because of all the stories you've done over the years.
Right, this is the 6-1.
It is the 6-1. And, you know, there's one year, actually, where I had a few extra creaks around my house and almost like some footsteps one night. I think that was 3 investigations ago. So.
Sure, do they like you?
Hopefully they didn't. It doesn't seem like they stayed around, but maybe they followed me home for a bit to see if it was an interesting place, and they're kind of bored. So,
how did you find this story? Because we've seen the one man who kind of walks around with that machine. We've seen him in stories in the past. How did you get this story?
Well, so Marcus, the investigator, he was a student at West Jordan Middle, and he just happened to be visiting there a little bit early in the year. I believe it was the summer. I'm not really sure the reason, but anyway, he goes in. A couple students say, are you here to investigate? Because apparently they'd seen a couple of our past investigations. He's like, well, no. And I guess he didn't realize that there are actually ghost stories surrounding this place. Wow. And in fact, some pretty compelling ones from the couple of people that you see in the story. Mm-hmm. So we got permission from Jordan School District to go in and investigate. And it was a really unique experience. I always kind of wanted to do a story about a place that was getting demolished and just... I don't know, maybe it's a sentimentality of just history kind of falling by the wayside, but I always feel like there's a good story there, and we hopefully found one in this case.
Oh, it was creepy. Yeah. It was so creepy. I was legitimately scared to watch it alone.
Oh, it was, I mean, all the sounds and the silence, it really added to it. But can you talk about, I don't know, I mean, on camera, of course, we're just hearing bits and pieces of what they actually said, but, I mean, what are these music teachers, these former librarians, what was the feel that you got from them?
Oh, I definitely felt like they believed everything that they told me, and they'd had some profound experiences there. I believe that the one had acknowledged that maybe she was a little bit more sensitive to those types of things, which, you know, over the years and just doing these types of stories, I mean, I do think that people are more receptive to experiences than others. But they were, I mean, just almost as if, like, for a moment, like, somebody was there on stage, like, right behind you. No, I'm just kidding. That doesn't. But basically, like that, and then they're gone, just like that, and they're able to, you know, visualize some of these things. But so we had a good basis of stories to go off of and investigate, and I thought we found some pretty interesting evidence. You know, that one scene where you see like the light almost zapping into Marcus' hand. I've never seen anything like that before on an investigation.
Did you see it as it happened or later on when you were going through the shots?
Going through the video. That's one thing is you meticulously have to go through all of your video after the fact. That alone probably took me, because I was the one that went through the video to find that's probably like 8 or 10 hours. I mean, it takes a little time to go through all that.
Right, yeah.
Man. And Tanner, you worked with Tanner, photojournalist Tanner. Yeah. He went through, I mean, the sounds or the lack of sounds, the silence, you know, through this packages. That really added to that feel. Did it feel that creepy when you were in the school?
It did at times. I remember one time I was walking alone down this hallway, and I've never been more terrified in any of our investigations. I don't know what it was. I don't know if something was following me, or maybe it was my own head. That's always the difficult thing as far as like experiences that you have on these, because they seem very profound to you, but it's like, how do you really relate that to people who want to see documentable evidence? But definitely a creepy feeling.
And you mentioned not everything was, I mean, it's difficult to include everything into this story. So was there anything that was left out?
Well, yeah, there was one really interesting piece that I thought was cool. So Marcus had to go outside and grab some AAA batteries. And so I had to let him in because the school was locked. Mm-hmm. We're the only people inside. So when he got back, he texted me, and I told the people around me, I was like, hey, I got to go get Marcus. He's out upstairs. And right at that moment, the word generating obvious device says outside. Like, almost like it was joining in the conversation. Ooh. And that's crazy. Legitimately crazy.
And were you scared to even, like, walk away from the group and go get Marcus?
I've seen a couple of things over the years, so maybe my amount of surprise wasn't quite as much. But that's the one thing you learn with these is never cease to be amazed or surprised, because all kinds of stuff can happen and always seems to one way or the other.
Wow. So, and my last question, do you have a story for next Halloween?
I'm still piecing that together on what that might be. I've always been fascinated with the idea of doing something maybe outdoors. We haven't done that yet. There are some haunted places in Utah that are outside and kind of spooky. I always feel like the woods anyway are kind of a spooky place.
Oh,
and
yeah.
So I don't know, maybe we'll examine that. But of course, you know, we're a year away, so I have some time to hash that out.
Right.
For sure. Andrew, thank you so much for joining
us. Yes, thank you very much.
We're legitimately scared. Thank you.